diabetes is a terrible disease, and it's growing rapidly. And I feel good that I think what's needed is innovation. Our laboratory and mouse work is important. It helps us ask fundamental questions, but ultimately we have to figure out, is this relevant to humans? If you look at fish oils, among the properties of fish oils is that they're anti-inflammatory. So since we know that inflammation is part of the cause of diabetes or pre-diabetes, we reason that giving fish oil to people may help relieve that inflammation, and therefore either prevent pre-diabetes or prevent the pro-inflammatory state and maybe improve the overall insulin-resistant metabolic syndrome picture. Doing what was done 20 years ago doesn't cut it. Clearly with diabetes, which is increasing rapidly, obviously doing the same old thing that we've been doing for years is obviously not going to work. There's a clear-cut need to innovate in all aspects of medical sciences.
Of course, clinical trials are important because they are our best evidence for efficacy and for moving forward in a way to improve some health disorder. For us, that's substance use disorders. Specifically, we look at, in our lab, the behavioral and pharmacological factors that contribute to stimulant abuse. Demonstrating that something has efficacy or that something maybe has better efficacy than another treatment that's in place is really crucial.
I mean, it's the end test of the intervention, be it a behavioral intervention or be it a medication. Laboratory research is very, very important for determining initial efficacy, and it can be done quicker and less expensively so that we can screen out medications that we don't think will work and only move forward the medications that we think have the greatest chance of success.
Substance abuse is a human condition, and we need to understand it and how it works in humans. And so we have to have volunteers who are willing to, come in and participate with us.
Sepsis is an overwhelming infection that disturbs many of the body's functions. And we don't have a good treatment for sepsis. We don't even have the best monitors for sepsis to tell when sepsis is starting or when it's starting to abate. So the clinical research that we're doing now is trying to develop a monitor that would be very sensitive to tell us when a patient is becoming septic or when they're getting better and responding to treatment. My hope is that the device will give us an early warning sign for patients who are deteriorating. So instead of just measuring heart rate or blood pressure, which is relatively crude, this device will tell us about the immune system in its entirety. It's really very exciting.
Clinical trials are the answer to cancer. Without clinical trials, we make no progress, and we would not be able to bring new drugs and new therapies to the people that suffer with cancer. So the Lung Cancer Research Initiative began with an idea and an observation. The observation was that we have the highest incidence of lung cancer in the country. It is even more pronounced in the southeastern part of the state. And we asked the question, why is that? Is that all because of smoking? Because, of course, smoking is the number one cause of lung cancer. And in looking at the epidemiology of the disease, it really can't be explained by smoking alone. And that's what began the questions that developed into this large study. And that is to look at trace element exposure, both in your occupation, in where you live, in the water you drink, in the soil around you, and also your genetic ability to clear carcinogens, to see if that plays a role in how lung cancer develops and why it develops so often in this area of the country. It's not been a challenge to actually find participants, and I'm very thankful for that. And I think that's because of the generosity of the people of this region, as well as their recognition that this is a terrible disease and anything they can do to help is they want to do. And that's a beautiful, beautiful gift to us. So it's a perfect marriage of an excellent group of patients who are willing to participate and good ideas from the scientists at the Markey Cancer Center brought together to create new therapies and make progress towards someday curing cancer.